The real question is, do you actually need the coaching classes to crack UGC NET examination in English literature? The answer is a big no. You don't need a coaching class to reach from where you are to where you want to go. No doubt coaching triggers your preparation, provided your coach is transparent with you to share the exact strategies that keeps the ball moving forward. But if your coach is not transparent with you, you may fail the exam one more time. Now, why does the coach do this? Because if you fail the examination, you are encouraged to join the coaching classes one more time. In fact, I too am coaching a number of students and helping them to shorten the gap between them and their dream of cracking UGC NET examination in English literature. But listen to me, I'm not trying to sell you my course, but what I am trying to sell you is the idea that you too can crack the examination without any assistance. In fact, there are hundreds of students who crack this examination every year without taking any coaching class. Moreover, there are thousands of students who join coaching classes every year, but out of these thousand students, only a few dozen students crack this examination. Coaching classes do not give damn about the students who fail to crack this examination. It is always those students who crack this examination get featured on the banners of these coaching classes. If you join a coaching class and if you fail this examination, no one cares about you. What does that simply mean? It simply means that efforts do not matter. It is only results that matter most. No matter how much efforts you put in this examination, if you fail to crack this examination or if you are not producing the desired results, no one is going to believe you. I will tell you what will happen if you fail this examination. The first time you will fail to crack this examination, you will think of giving another try. You will think that in second attempt you will clear this examination. And if you fail this examination one more time, you will start doubting yourself. The next time you join a coaching class, and even if you still fail to crack this examination, your parents and family members start doubting you. In your fourth attempt, neither you will believe in yourself nor your parents. You will create a sort of aura around you that you are not good enough. I have seen students who have taken the coaching classes yet failed to crack any examination. They have gathered all kinds of notes of the universe. They have joined all types of coaching classes available in the market. Yet again, they will fail to crack the examination in their fourth or fifth attempt. It simply means that coaching classes will not help you until you yourself decide to help yourself. Now, what does that mean? It simply means that you will fail the examination because you are unable to find your strengths. And no matter how much notes you gather, you will fail this examination. The number one thing that you have to understand is your strengths. Rather than focusing on your weaknesses, try to focus on your strengths. Maybe you are good at reading books, or maybe you love watching movies and documentaries. When I was working as an assistant professor, there was a colleague of mine. He was basically a lawyer, and his memory was so sharp that he knew all the poems by John Keats, P.B. Shelley, S.T. Coleridge by heart. Even he remembered all the ghazals of Mir Taqi Mir, Iqbal, Mirza Ghalib. And we all colleagues used to sit together every night and celebrate the moments. This colleague of mine was a lawyer, yet he knew a lot about English literature. He knew a lot about Henry David Thoreau, Ralph Waldo Emerson. He remembered dozens of sonnets written by William Shakespeare. I have read over 300 and 400 books, yet I am unable to remember even a single poem. The strength of my colleague was his memory. Being a lawyer, he can remember facts, cases, and incidents in great depth. My strength is critical thinking. My exposure to Gita, Quran, Bible, Guru Granth Sahib developed my critical thinking. I used to read one sentence from Quran or Bible and kept on thinking about single sentence for hours and hours and days. Critical thinking was my strength and it helped me to understand English literature sooner than anyone else. I want to ask you, what is your strength? Do you love watching movies? Go on and watch 3 to 4 movies every single day on important writers and important works. Do you love reading books? Go and read 2 to 3 books every week. In fact, I know all the works of Shakespeare chronologically through a drawing. Whenever there is a question from Shakespeare's work in examination, I draw that drawing and all the 36 or 37 plays appear before me like a magic. What is your strength? If you have no strength, then develop one and practice it over and over again. Remember that what Bruce Lee said, "I fear not the man who has practiced 10,000 kicks once, but I fear the man who has practiced one kick 10,000 times." You might have read S.T. Coleridge's Kublai Khan. Kublai Khan was one of the greatest king of Mongolian Empire, and there was a Zen master who used to fight for the army of Kublai Khan. Here is the secrets he shared with his soldiers. This Zen master writes, "Practice preparation, endless repetition, until the mind is weary and your bones ache, until you are too tired to sweat and weak to breath. Practice, practice and practice." That's what I suggest you. Pick one strength of you and repeat it thousands and hundreds of times. That's how you crack this examination, whether you join the coaching classes or not. So I hope you found this video worth of your time. If you have any query, drop your questions in the comments below. I make sure to resolve all your doubts in my upcoming videos. If you're new to this channel and have not subscribed to this channel yet, then don't forget to subscribe the channel for more updates on English literature. So that's it for this video. Thank you.